हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम सुनील कुमार एंड आई एम बैक विद अ न्यू वीडियो। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू नीट एग्जाम। सो द डेट हैज बीन पास, सो यू कैन से 26 जुलाई 2020 इज माई डे, द डे व्हेन आई एम गोइंग टू रॉक द एग्जाम, द डे व्हेन आई एम गोइंग टू प्रूव माई सेल्फ। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी फोकसिंग ऑन टाइम टेबल, चैप्टर्स दैट यू नीड टू स्टडी अलॉट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू योर नीट एग्जाम, the next 80 days program, what you are going to do for the next 80 days. I promise you one very important statement, students. If this next coming 80 days you work as per the timetable that I give you in this video, there is a guarantee that you will be selected for the NEET exam, trust me. But you need to follow strictly and strongly the timetable that I'm going to give you for the next 80 days. If you start from tomorrow, so tomorrow is your day one. On the 25th, you will say, yes, I am waiting. I am waiting for this 26 July. And for denge, we are going to score good marks in the NEET exam. And if you can see, it says, I can do it and I will do it. Look at the score that the child has written on the card. This is your score, 650 out of 720. This is your score. This is what you need to score to get a seat in medical, and this video will guide you for that. Watch the video till the end. I will be discussing most important parts, and if this video goes bit longer, still you observe the video. At least if you invest 5-10 minutes extra in this video, it will be helping you a lot. So let's get started without wasting a single minute. How many days are there? So I say 80 days. This is my deadline. So whenever I talk about 80 days, I bifurcate this 80 days as 75 days and 5 days. So let us take it in this way, 75 days separately and 5 days separately. This 75 days I will be putting under three main days, let's say 25 days, 25 days and 25 days. So these 25 days for each subject that you study, it's like physics, chemistry and biology. See, you are not at 0%, you need to understand. You have been studying bit. So now this 80 days plan is going to act as a booster. And still if you have not started, still it will be a successful plan so that you can at least land up between 400 to 500 score if you are at zero. But I'm very much sure no one is at zero. You are studying, even in the lockdown period you are studying. So let's understand, 24 hours that you are having in one day is very much crucial. You are going to plan your 24 hours for the next coming 80 days in such a way that you get one medical seat. Just try to follow the schedule which I give you today. It will be a bit difficult, but without hard work nothing can be achieved. I will say, put it in this way, the day starts at 6 a.m. in the morning. So this is where you are going to get up. Okay, 6 a.m. just get up. Now 6 to 7, I give you 1 hour time, 6 to 7, 1 hour time. You just fresh up, or even if you want to do some exercise, you have your bath. And exactly at 7, get ready. This is very important. Hot water and lemon. Because we all know in lemon there is vitamin C. And this vitamin C is going to act as an antioxidant. So it will fresh up your mind. But have this, because this vitamin C, which is going to act as an antioxidant, it will reduce or it will decrease all the free radicals of your body, making your body fresh and energetic. From 7 to 10, okay, from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. just study the subject which you love or you don't love, I don't know, but you need to study physics. 7 to 10, just study physics, nothing else. That is what you need to take care of. And once you have done this, have a 1 hour break. Then 11, again you start your session. So 11 to 2 p.m. for 1 hour break, go for chemistry. Now this is very important. 3 hours, you go for chemistry. Again take 1 hour break. Okay. फ्रॉम 3 PM टू 6 PM यू स्टडी बायोलॉजी. नीड टू स्टडी दोज चैप्टर्स विच यू फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट, विच यू फाउंड लाइक इट्स नॉट इजी और आई हैव लेफ्ट सम पार्ट. स्टार्ट विद दोज चैप्टर्स. दिस इज वेरी क्रूशियल टाइम बिकॉज दिस प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल स्टूडेंट्स. फ्रॉम 7 to 10 PM you are going to solve papers. You are going to solve papers. And you are going to solve complete papers. Now, when I say complete paper means, here you are going to solve the paper of 720 marks. No matter what you score, no matter what you score, okay? But out of 720, just try to solve. That is very important. Try to solve the paper. And you see your score day by day when you are studying one chapter. So definitely your score is going to rise day by day. But from tomorrow, solve one paper. Now the question comes here, from where I should get the paper? Where are the papers, you know? From where to get the paper? See, there are many Telegram groups which provide the question paper every day. So you can join them. There are many YouTubers who are helping in that way, providing one paper every day. So you can solve that. Even on my Telegram, I provide one paper every day that I have been doing since last 2-3 days, where every day I post one paper, students solve in the morning and they get the answer in the evening, then they prepare for the next day. So like that, solve 80 papers. This is very important. See, when you solve, let's take for example, you have solved the paper, okay? Once you have solved the papers, there is a possibility of getting wrong answers. So the moment you get wrong answer, what you need to do? Write the question and answer in a notebook. Make a separate notebook, question and answer in notebook. What you do, you know, you make a separate notebook. And in the separate notebook, write the answers for those questions which you got wrong. Okay. And like that, what will happen? You will create a separate set of guide, you can say, a set of book that will help you to understand, okay, this is something what I was wrong in. And slowly, slowly, you will be becoming master in that part. Because things that you do wrong, you always remember, oh, because of this reason, I missed it. Now, coming to the next part. So you will say, sir, from 7 to 10, I'm studying physics, 11 to 2, chemistry. Then in this situation where I will be doing my notebook part, where I will be correcting myself. See students, here you are having what? You are having 1 hour gap. Now in this gap, no, if you solve one paper one day, so out of 45 questions, let us say you got 10 wrong. So to write the 10 questions, I'm not telling you to solve or I'm not telling you to put in a proper way. Just write it in a notebook. How much time it takes? Hardly it takes 15 minutes. Or let us take it take 30 minutes. So in 1 hour gap, 30 minutes, you just make your notes for the questions which you have attempted wrong. So all the wrong answers which you got, just write. So in 30 minutes, you write for physics. Then again, when there is gap, so next 30 minutes, again, you make a note for chemistry. And from 6 to 6:30, 30 minutes, you make notes for biology. If you study in this way, you are going to definitely succeed in your NEET exam. It totally depends on your passion for the exam. Because to study 10 to 12 hours, 15 hours requires only one very important step, that is called as passion. If you have passion to achieve a NEET seat, if you have a passion to see yourself that yes, one seat is mine, one seat of MBBS is mine. If you have this passion, you know, then only it is possible to crack. Now this timetable you need to follow for the next 80 days. So we are going for the first basic chapter, that you all subject that you call it as physics. Now in physics, we have 11th and we have 12th. Now since I'm a biology teacher, I will not be able to guide you much with respect to physics. But looking at this graph, I can understand one thing. From 11th physics, you need to focus on this topic very much. Start with this topic, that is the laws of motion. This is the first to be done. And looking at the second one, you have to go for properties of bulk matter. This is the second topic to be done very nicely and strongly. And after that, the third, I can say it is the motion of the system of particles and rigid body. You need to follow this. After that, go on to the kinetic theory of gases, thermodynamics, the fourth part. Then you go on to oscillation and waves, the fifth part. You work on gravitation, that becomes the sixth part. Kinematics, seventh. Physics, physical world and measurements, you can go for eighth. And last, you can go for work, energy and power. So like this, you need to follow these chapters, because this graph indicates the number of questions that came in the NEET exam with respect to the chapters. So this is the order how you should start studying physics for 11th. And the moment you go for 12th, no need to say the topic that you need to study very well thoroughly is nothing but the optics first, because 23% question comes from this topic. Then you need to focus on electrostatics, the second part. After electrostatic, students go on to the dual nature of matter and radiation, that is atom and nuclei. After that, you focus on magnetic effect of electric current. After that, you can talk about current electricity. See, remember the order of the study. If you follow this order, it will be useful for you. Then you can go for electromagnetic induction, that is EMI. And then you can go for electronic device. So this is what you need to study. Now, chemistry is when you are into physical chemistry, organic chemistry and inorganic chemistry. So when I talk about NEET physical chemistry for class 11th, the part that you need to study the most is the equilibrium. First, always do equilibrium first. And after that, you need to go for the redox reaction related stuff. That is very important. Then you go for the thermodynamics. It is very important to be covered. Then you can go for structure of atom. That is the fourth part. And then you can study some basic concept of chemistry and states of matter. That is gaseous, liquid and solid. For 12th point of view, the chapters that are there in 12th, which one is the most important one? So I can say here there are three important parts that is very important simultaneously. So I will give it number one to all three. You need to study solution, then you need to study chemical kinetics, and you need to study the electrochemistry. All three, one, because this is very important. Whichever you love, start doing first. And on number two, I will say just go on to the surface chemistry. And third, I will say go on to solid state from 12th channel. So this is the way of studying the chapters of physics, chemistry with respect to NEET, that is physical chemistry. Inorganic chemistry with respect to 11th standard. The first chapter that you are going to finish will be this one. That is S block elements, you can say element alkali and alkaline earth metal, 25%. Then after that, move on to some P block elements, that is again a huge percentage, accounting for 25%. After that, you can do chemical bonding and molecular structure. Third, fourth, you can go for environmental chemistry. Fifth, you can focus on classification of elements, periodicity, and then you can go for hydrogen. So this is inorganic chemistry chapter, which you need to do with respect to your 11th standard. The moment you talk about 12th standard students, the chapter that you need to focus the most is the P block element. There is no other option. If you do P block element, you can understand 57% from the 12th standard weightage is only to the P block. And after that, you are going for general principles and process isolation, where the various mechanism is involved for isolation. Then you need to focus on this D and F block element. And in the last, you can go for coordinate compound. So these are the, you can say, the chapters that you need to follow with the order. If you focus on these chapters, you can easily score good marks, students. Coming to the organic chemistry, now it is combined 11th and 12th. So first you need to focus on, first very important is the hydrocarbon. Just do hydrocarbons, 28% of the organic chemistry is done. After going to organic hydrocarbons, please move on to alcohol, phenols and ethers, that is 18%. And after that, it's all 9%. So whichever you feel like, see, these chapters are easy. So you can go for chemistry in everyday life. Then you can study polymers. This is also quite easy. You can study biomolecules, aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acid you can study. Go for aromatic compounds. So these are very important chapters basically, because they include 99%. But 1, 2 and 3 has to be done very nicely, because it is going to help you to score better marks for chemistry. Okay. So when we talk about this 11th and 12th botany part, so we are going to do biology as botany and zoology. So which part comes the most in the botany section? So we have plant physiology. I can say first to be done. Do this first. Okay, it's easy basically. And the second part that you need to focus is genetics and evolution. This is the second one. Even though it is 21%, I take it as second, because plant physiology is quite easy as compared to genetics. And after that, go for ecology. This is the most preferred chapter. So third, I will put ecology as the preference. And after that, I will go for cell structure and the function, which includes biomolecules, cell division and all. So the fourth part. Then you are going for the structural organization of animals and plants, fifth. Sexual reproduction in flowering plants, sixth. And at the last, you can go for diversity in living world. And at the end, not forgetting this, a small chapter but important one, that is microbes in human welfare. When it comes to zoology students, the chapters that you need to focus the most here is human physiology. If you do this, ye kar dala, then life is jhinga lala. That is very important, human physiology. After moving on to human physiology, you have to go for biology and human welfare. That is the second most important one. After that, you are going to talk about reproduction. That is again important. This is the third to be done. Then we are doing biotechnology, the fourth to be done. Fifth, we are going to focus on evolution aspect. Sixth, biomolecules. Okay. Then we have the seventh one, that is you can do animal kingdom, structural organization from zoological aspect. And at the last, you can go for breathing and exchange of gases. So this is the order of the chapters that you need to do for physics, chemistry and biology. Just stick to this timetable, getting up at 6 and till 10 at night you have to do. See, I have given you ample time for sleep, I have given you how to start your day, and eat well, sleep well and drink well, because now 80 days is not going to change. It's all in your hand. And remember what I want to say, abhi nahi to kabhi nahi. I can do it, I will do it. Follow the rules and you will get a seat in medical. This is Sunil sir saying goodbye to you. Any doubt, any problem with respect to NEET exam, you can always join my Telegram. Ask your doubts, solve the papers. All the best students, start studying now. Start studying now. Thank you.